What is a quantum membrane? What will unlocking the secrets of the quantum world mean for humanity? Somewhere, there is a missing link between the world of the super small ruled by quantum mechanics and the macroscopic world that we interact with every day that will help scientists merge their theories of both. Could this new discovery contain the missing information needed to accomplish this? The field of quantum mechanics is full of bizarre interactions and almost otherworldly phenomena. New discoveries in this field of physics are always met with intrigue and excitement, and this new discovery was no different. A team of researchers studying powerful gravitational events across the cosmos stumbled upon a phenomenon that has been long theorized, a quantum membrane surrounding two black holes currently merging together, an event now named GW19052. With this discovery, scientists are hoping to advance their understanding of one particular subject within the umbrella of quantum mechanics, the study of quantum gravity. Scientists who study quantum gravity are attempting to merge the theory of gravity with the theory of quantum mechanics. Unifying these two theories is a necessary step in understanding what happened during the first instances of the universe's existence, at a time when our current models of the universe all fail to work. But unfortunately, this has proved more difficult than you would imagine, because gravity seems to somewhat break down and stops behaving as we expect it to when scientists try to view its interactions at the quantum level. The reason behind this altercation in the behavior of gravity is still unknown, but for some reason, gravity stops functioning as science understands it on very small scales. In addition to tiny scales, gravity is also known to behave differently in another situation that may contain a plethora of its own clues to how gravity functions on the quantum level, black holes. Still remaining one of the top subjects for any research involving gravity, black holes are still not understood as fully as some physicists would prefer. One physicist, Paul Davies, has even said that explaining what happens to anything that falls in explodes our current theories of physics. Within the black hole, beyond its outer boundary of the event horizon, is another world, and science is still not clear what exactly happens there. But this team's discovery wasn't concerned with what was inside of the event horizon, but with what was right outside, fully engulfing the newly forming black hole. Some theoretical physicists today believe it will take studying the gravity in regions just outside of these gravitational monsters to unlock the mysteries of quantum gravity, as well as increase our knowledge of black holes, and now they will have their chance at doing just that. Earlier this year, a team of physicists from around the world came together to study and analyze the data recorded from the massive gravitational wave emitted after the GW19052 event. And buried in this information, the researchers found the evidence they were looking for that proved to them that a quantum membrane was present around this black hole. This membrane, also referred to as a stretched horizon, is thought to influence the behavior of both gravitational fields as well as non-gravitational fields like the magnetic field in the regions around the black hole. But studying these effects, scientists may be able to learn more about the structure and function of quantum membranes, as well as the role of gravity in this quantum phenomenon. This new discovery might present the information needed to finally grasp the holy grail of physics, the unification of general relativity and quantum mechanics. Trying to use the principles of quantum mechanics to describe gravity may sound like a relatively simple thing, but has proved to be a much more difficult task. One of the main issues is how difficult experimental verification is because of how few experiments exist that could even run a test on the quantum level. The energy scale at which quantum gravity acts and would need to be studied is orders of magnitude larger than the energies achieved even during the largest collisions in the most powerful particle accelerators of the world. So this means that scientists studying this will need to be smart and come up with some other way of studying gravity on a quantum level. Finding this evidence of the quantum membrane gave them just that. A huge cache of information collected during the event will give them an unprecedented look into the world of quantum gravity. The team of researchers working to decode all the information gathered from GW19052 immediately got to work verifying what they found by referencing what the models and theories say these membranes are like. One of the features that theories predicted about stretched horizons are that there is a tiny gap in between the event horizon and the quantum membrane itself, measuring on the order of the Planck length. And this is exactly what they found. The Planck length refers to the scale at which classical theories like gravity and space-time no longer hold and quantum mechanics takes over. One Planck length is tiny, roughly 1.6 times 10 to the negative 35 meters, nearly 20 orders of magnitudes, 100 million trillion times smaller than the diameter of a proton. The existence of the quantum membrane tells physicists to expect a rarely seen phenomenon called a gravitational echo. As the black holes collided and merged together, their event horizons became one and a gravitational wave was emitted out of the newly formed black hole's body. And this gravitational wave can be powerful. In the final milliseconds of merging, the gravitational radiation that gets released can exceed the combined energy of all the light waves emanating from all the stars in the entire observable universe. But as this gravitational wave leaves the event horizon, some of it gets reflected off of the quantum membrane. This reflection will then bounce off of the event horizon and escape again through the quantum membrane, essentially just an echo of the first gravitational wave. The researchers knew that if they could pour through the data and find evidence of this echo, it would all but confirm that they did indeed find the first quantum membrane. After many hours of searching, the team's analysis paid off and they found the signature of a gravitational wave echo that arrived at the LIGO detector 1.1 second after the main portion of the wave. The echo came back around 10% of the total energy of the merger event, which still packed quite a punch. In addition to the gravitational echoes, researchers also look for a telltale sign of a black hole merger that are emitted during the phase of merging called ring down. This phase occurs as the two black holes have merged into one and begin to settle. But as it settles, it oscillates back and forth extremely quickly, broadcasting out more gravitational waves that decrease in strength as the newly formed black hole comes to rest. Because of the strength of the gravitational waves produced during a black hole merger event, facilities like LIGO and European Virgo can pick up the waves generated at an insane distance away from Earth. So far, researchers working at these gravitational wave detectors have found nearly 50 merger events. And as their methods of detection and analysis get better, that number is expected to rise rather rapidly. The researchers hope that by using the gravitational wave detectors that we currently have, along with building the next generation of them, will allow researchers to capture more of these quantum membranes being formed during black hole merger events, and be able to study them and their structure in much greater detail. We are now at a time when the unification of quantum mechanics with a world of macroscopic physics may not be too far off. Thanks for watching. Do you think the unification of quantum mechanics and gravity will happen soon? And what kind of impact do you think it will have on the scientific community? See you next time on Matter.